Hello, I'm Alex, this is LibreGraphics World. Let's talk about new Blade and Ocean Sobiego-based filters in GIMP. This new feature is coming in the next version of the program, which is 2.10.20. As usual, there is no schedule, but it's probably 1 or 2 months away from now. The reason I want to talk about this new feature is that it might not make a lot of sense to you unless you understand the background, so I think it's a good idea to clear it up. When you run any Gogo-based filters with a non-canvas preview, you can now choose a blending mode and change opacity directly in the filters dialog. This feature replaces the fade command that was removed from GIMP a little over a year ago. The reason for removal was that the leaf preview on the canvas required creating at least one copy of the layer you were working on. So in case of large images, doing fade resulted in really slow operation. The new implementation is way faster and it opens some really neat possibilities for when non-distortive editing becomes available in version 3.2. But let's get back to that in a minute. Right now, in a destructive context, this means you have two workflows for applying Gogo-based filters. Let's have a close look. Supposing you want to boost details in a photo, one of the common solutions here is using the high-pass filter. Here is how it usually works. You load a photo, duplicate the original layer, change its mode to something like linear light, open the high-pass filter dialog and start tweaking both filter settings and layer opacity to control the effect. Then you apply the filter. Since you worked on a separate layer, you do retain some control over the effect after you have applied it. You can change opacity of the layer to control the strength of the effect, and you can also try other blending modes. So this is how you probably already use filters. While GIMP only provides a kind of destructive workflow for filters, I can think of just a few use cases where this would come in handy. Supposing you are short on system resources and you know what you're doing and you don't care about destructive editing all that much. In that case, you would just apply a filter with the blending options you need and continue adding other changes into that layer, then export, close and be done with it. Now, what it means for future non-destructive workflow is that you will be able to do something like this. Select a layer that is in, say, multiply mode and 60% of opacity, and then apply a filter with, let's just say, screen blended mode and 75% of opacity. At any time later, you will be able to reopen that XCF file and adjust filter settings, including its blending options. So the net effect would be multifold. First, you would get more control of your work, secondly, a cleaner workflow, and finally, you would go a little easier on system resources. Again, all this will come in version 3.2. So while this new feature may not be something you would immediately make use of, it's a very much welcome step towards more sophisticated workflows in the future. Thank you for watching and see you soon.